السلام عليكم guys. Recently we've all seen this amazing footage of the most heroic man in the 21st century. But as you know, freedom of speech rules don't really apply to those criminals. The last time I talked about them, I got banned for 1 year. So, if we can't really talk about them, I can remind you of a very, very important hero from our history. His name was Ja'far ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. In the Battle of Mu'tah, remember when the Muslim army were 3,000 men while trying to fight the Roman army, which were 200,000 soldiers? Please let the numbers sink in. 3,000 men against 200,000 Romans. During the battle, Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, our hero for today, was holding the flag with one hand, and he was fighting courageously. Then his hand was cut off. So he decided to hold the Muslim flag with his other hand, and then his other hand also was cut off. So he held the Muslim flag with the remaining parts of his cut off arms, and then he died as a shaheed, a martyr. The Prophet, peace and blessing be upon him, said, "I see him in paradise with two wings flying with angels." Now let me add more fake details to the story of Ja'far that are completely made up and have no resemblance to our reality. Ja'far was leading those 2,000 Muslims fighting against the 200,000 Roman disbelievers. He was not leading his small army by staying safely in the back in an air-conditioned room. No, he was in the front lines with his soldiers, fighting with courage, as he knew that his life was not more valuable than theirs. This is something that no leader in the world today would ever do. After they cut off his hand, they were still afraid to fight him man to man. So they cowardly sent a drone in to see the monster they are afraid of. He waited for the drone to come near him to hit it with a stick. The only stick that he had left after he lost his weapon and he lost his hand in the process. The coward flying the drone with a remote control was able to dodge the hit of the stick. Then they thought, "We can't really fight a 60 years old man with one hand with a stick. That is very dangerous." Instead, they hit the whole building he was in with a tank shot. A tank shot to kill a 60 years old man with one hand with a stick. May Allah reward our hero, Ja'far ibn Abi Talib, of course, and grant us the opportunity to be 1% as good as him.
أنا أقول بأنه أكبر هدية يمكن أن يقدمها العدو والاحتلال لي هو أن يغتالني وأن أقضي إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى شهيدا على يده. أنا اليوم عمري 59 سنة. أنا حقيقة أفضل أن أستشهد بالـ F-16 أو بالصواريخ من إني أموت بالكورونا.
One final reminder. Those cowards who were afraid to detain an old man with one hand with a stick, those cowards who decided to shoot a whole building with a tank, didn't even consider that this building might have civilians or children in it. They didn't even consider that this building might have a basement filled with hostages, right? They don't really care. Just think about it and please never stop talking and never stop sharing. الساكت عن الحق شيطان أخرس. The one who is silent in front of evil is a silent shaitan.
He was resisting until his final breath.
You have to say no politician in America, Europe, nobody would ever die like that.
He survived a tank attack, a drone attack that blew off his arm, and he still fought them to the very end. This guy, love him or hate him, pulled off one of the most spectacular military maneuvers in modern history.
Because he can't move anymore, so he picks up a stick and waits for the drone to get close enough that he can whack it, and it doesn't, so instead, he chucks it like a spear with his last breath.
Rest in peace, the fallen leader of the resistance against the genocidal, insane, evil occupy.
Like a Hollywood star, Kevin. keffiyeh around his neck, one arm amputated, and with the other arm throwing a stick at a drone that's about to kill him, and he looked unbelievably relaxed.
He was wearing body armor with a rifle in his hand and basically had run out of ammunition fighting off US soldiers.
He used it trying to free the people around him, knowing full well that his fight was going to lead to his own death.
I have a lot that I really want to say about this, but instead of me saying it, I will ask you to listen to this part of the Quran with me. Don't go before you listen and make sure you get the message from the verses. Salaam alaikum.
زين لهم سوء أعمالهم والله لا يهدي القوم الكافرين يا أيها الذين آمنوا ما لكم إذا قيل لكم انفروا في سبيل الله ما لكم إذا قيل لكم انفروا في سبيل الله اثاقلتم إلى الأرض أرضيتم بالحياة الدنيا من الآخرة فما متاع الحياة الدنيا في الآخرة إلا قليل إلا تنفروا يعذبكم عذابا أليما إلا تنفروا يعذبكم عذابا أليما ويستبدل قوما غيركم ولا تضروه شيئا والله على كل شيء قدير إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا فأنزل الله سكينته عليه وأيده بجنود لم ترها وجعل كلمة الذين كفروا السفلى وكلمة الله هي العليا والله عزيز حكيم انفروا خفافا وثقالا وجاهدوا بأموالكم وأنفسكم في سبيل الله ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون لو كان عرضا قريبا وسفرا قاصدا لاتبعوك ولكن بعدت عليهم الشقة وسيحلفون بالله لو استطعنا لخرجنا معكم يهلكون أنفسهم والله يعلم إنهم لكاذبون عفى الله عنك لما أذنت لهم حتى يتبين لك الذين صدقوا وتعلم الكاذبين لا يستأذنك الذين يؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر أن يجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم والله عليم بالمتقين إنما يستأذنك الذين لا يؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر واليوم الآخر وارتابت قلوبهم فهم في ريبهم يترددون ولو أرادوا الخروج لأعدوا له عدة ولكن كره الله انبعاثهم فثبطهم وقيل اقعدوا مع القاعدين لو خرجوا فيكم ما زادوكم لو خرجوا فيكم ما زادوكم إلا خبالا ولأوضعوا خلالكم يبغونكم الفتنة وفيكم سماعون لهم والله عليم بذات الصدور.